Hey guys, we're here today with Cliff, one of our lead design engineers, and we want to look back at the development of our C1500 kit. Let's check it out. Hey everyone, we're here today. We're going to look back at one of our new products we had launched, our C1500 kit. We're here with Cliff, one of our lead design engineers who worked on the project. And we want to look back at the project and just kind of understand the development and the time that we put into it. So I guess, Cliff, help us understand when we first set out on this project, what goals did we have before kicking things off?
Sure. So as a company, we kind of have this whole design plan for each one of our projects. And each organization or each piece of our company has a say in the design and the process that we go through. And by the time it gets down to me, to where I actually get to take apart the car, scan it, design prototypes, produce parts, a lot of the concepts are already kind of handed down and narrowed in at that point. So I would say I'm probably at the 30% mark in the project. That's when my job role starts.
So by the time we get, this is Jack Durant. We've lovingly endeared the name Jack Durant here for this truck you're buying. So yep. By the time it rolls in, about 30% of the project has already been vetted. You've worked with, you know, defining what the customer needs are and different things of that nature.
Yep, exactly, right? Exactly.
Now, what are some of the things that you learned through that process that that really help mold and define what we're trying to build here?
Sure. A lot of the comments on previous projects are what guide our steps moving forward. QA1 as a company, we go for drivability. We want that car on the road as much as possible and have it be able to be versatile in drag racing, in autocross, in just the street cruise down on downtown Panaprog.
Panaprog, yeah.
Just being able to show off your car. And so all of the goals of it are so broad. So narrowing those in and making it versatile is kind of number one for me. Also, all the different platforms, say for this one, an extended cab, short box, a long box, standard cab, like all the different variants of this car, we have to make this kit work for all of those.
But so, not sacrifice any major performance or installation experience type of elements.
Exactly. And that is the trick, and finding those common areas of each vehicle frame, where the gas tank sits. Some of them have two gas tanks. So, you know, all of those different variables that go into it, it's pretty challenging, but pretty fun to chase that project.
Yeah, absolutely. I know something that we really focus on is the installation experience. I know that mm-hmm. posed some significant challenges for the engineering team this go around.
For sure.
Because one of the requirements we have with all of our truck kits is that installation, especially for the rear, is done with the cab and the bed on the chassis, yep. right? And with the gas tank on this truck being inside the frame rail, center of the truck,
yep.
how did that present issues for you? And what were some creative solutions to kind of overcome that?
So in the C10 project and the F100 project, we were able to do a cross member for our torque arm that cuts frame rail to frame rail, adds a little bit of rigidity to the frame, and it's just a much simpler way of doing it. Where this, the gas tank is right here, right in the middle on that side of the frame. So the cross member that we had to put in, not only has to be strong enough, it has to avoid all these critical components. We have to attempt to make room for exhaust, drive shaft, and then still keep in mind those frames that are long frames, extended cab frames. All of those variables come into one. So with this particular one, the cross member is at an angle, ties to the existing gas tank cross member, and we have this this special tab that goes in, so you can actually hook it in and around and bolt through some holes that you don't have to take the bed off to do, which is huge. That alone, just space in your garage, storage, makes the project go so much easier not having to remove that gas tank bed, drive shaft, like all of those things, being able to keep them in place for the common guy in the garage.
Yeah. Now, I'm smirking because I'm reflecting to your project in your garage, how it's expanded and blown apart into taking up the space of multiple vehicles. I think it's a good point, though, that storage of the bed is difficult.
Yes.
And just taking it off and on is something that I think we found a really clever solution, so hats off to you guys on that. I think it's really neat. Now, we design the kit. We go through all the validation of, you know, fitment and things of that nature, but now is when the vehicle hits the road, right? And you spoke to drivability and how important that is. Not only getting that stance, right, which is critical. Everybody needs that perfect stance, but how do you make it low but ride and perform really well? So what type of testing, what did we do to ensure that that performance was there?
Sure. So from the engineering side, we do a lot of FEA before any parts are even made. We actually run through a majority of our parts through a finite element analysis where we put a simulated load into the part and bend it or torque it or whatever that part is going to be subjected to. We apply those loads and see what happens. So we have a good idea of what will happen on the road. We then go on to a more physical test. In the case of this one, we tested that cross member I want to say somewhere in the 6,000 pound range, where we added a load cell, a bottle jack. We actually did it on the four posts we have behind here. Rigged everything down rigid, put dial indicators to find out what kind of displacements we get, what kind of twists, and we're seeing, you know, success with our products in the way that they match our FEA. So kind of getting that warm fuzzy of, we designed it to this. This is what we're actually seeing. All right, now let's put it on the road. We also do a lot of data acquisition. We can put sensors on the vehicle. For the example of a torque arm, we can put a load cell in the actual torque arm and find out what kind of forces are going through the torque arm and go from there.
Right, so we take it on the road. We will set up a closed track. Yep. We'll run it through its paces, not only just on a, you know, getting user impressions, whether it be a series of us hopping in the truck and putting down, you know, our feedback on the spring rate combination, the valving, but then also the truck's rig with that acquisition again. So we're able to look at it from a lot of different angles. So that's really neat. One thing I really enjoy just observing with the projects that we do is oftentimes there's these little details or little elements that are worked into the project that oftentimes don't get the spotlight because we're talking about the coilovers, we're talking about the torque arm, or these different more significant elements. But are there any elements of this project in particular that you're especially proud of or it's unique that most people won't notice?
So this one in particular, I can't say quite as much on this one. The F100 has a little Easter egg on it, which nobody has found. I have not heard a single word from anybody.
Care to have any hints on what it might be?
Where's QA1 located?
In Minnesota.
Yeah. Okay.
Leave it at that?
Yep.
All right.
A nice little Easter egg somewhere in the F100 project. But a lot of those design concepts even transferred over to here. It's just so fun taking some lines that maybe some people don't have, for instance, a certain cutout, say, of a logo and placement of it. Finding those people in our organization and outside of our organization, and those little details that people love and hate, and designing around those things.
Sure.
That's been interesting, trying to tuck those little details in, all while keeping an engineering mind to it, keeping the parts strong, as well as aesthetic.
Yeah, no, I hear you. Now, looking back at the project as a whole, you know, the project's done, it's out there, we're getting, you know, raving reviews from our fans and the people that have them on their trucks. You know, really people are just ecstatic with what we've been able to transform their truck into.
Yep.
From your perspective, you know, someone who is so intimately involved with the project from start to finish, what are you most proud of looking back at this one?
So me as a design engineer, my pride and joy is seeing it on the road and seeing mm-hmm. people actually using it out in the wild. I think I've seen three F100s with our kit. I've seen probably eight C10s with our kit. And along lines with this one, like, I have a little bit of love for this particular chassis just because this is the truck that I loved growing up. And being able to work on it has been a little bit of a little dream of mine.
Yeah, so, and those are just the trucks locally too.
Yes, exactly. Just yeah. a couple car shows within the 100 miles that I've been to.
Right.
So
right.
It's pretty cool to see.
Yeah, well, that's cool. Well, thanks for watching. Hopefully you found this entertaining. If you have any questions on this system here, on this 1500 OBS truck, you know, make sure to check that out on QA1.net or any other system that we have. And any questions you might have for us, make sure to hit us up on the tech line. Make sure you subscribe and follow us here on this YouTube channel. And most importantly, go drive it.